Where do you go from here? This is the question. You know, when you have so many challenges that you face daily, you face financial challenges, you face mental challenges, you face relationship challenges, you face the loss of loved ones, and you just wonder, you know, when is this going to stop? When is it going to stop? You ask yourself, the only thing that we can control is how we react in the midst of a crisis. How do we react in the midst of a challenge? How do we react in the midst of an obstacle? Obstacles are always going to be there. You have to decide, how are you going to react and move forward through the obstacle, around the obstacle, above the obstacle, under the obstacle? What are you going to do? Because life is going to throw all types of things at you. If you have a vision for your life and you know that you're destined for something, that God has given you a passion for something that you know that you have to do, it's always going to be something that is going to get in the way. And for you that don't know your purpose, you have a purpose. We all have a purpose. We were put here to do something other than buy cars and buy clothes and to pay bills. We all have a purpose for uplifting others, helping others, guiding others. We all have a purpose. The problem is we get caught up in our own stuff. Everything is about us. It's our bills, our challenges. Oh, my loved one passed. I can't do this. My job is crazy. And we get wrapped up in that stuff that we miss the opportunity to serve. We miss the opportunity to make someone smile. We miss that opportunity because we're in our own stuff, our own depression, our own moment, that we forget that there's a greater calling on your life. You know, you have a vision for yourself that nobody else can see. They're going to tell you you're crazy. Why would you do that? It doesn't make sense. You're never going to make money at that. You're not going to be good at it. I don't know why you would even think about that. Everybody has a say-so about your life, while they're not having a say-so about their own life. You're going to lose friends. You're going to lose supporters. Even your family's going to step back from you. But you know what? You have faith in what God has put in you, the vision in you that nobody else can see. You're the crazy one. Nobody else can see it. Think about Moses when he was building the ark. Nobody could see that there was going to be rain. Nobody believed him when he said that there was going to be rain. But he believed in the word of God and what God had told him to do. And he did that regardless of what everybody else had to say or regardless of what everybody else saw. So I'm just telling you guys, life is challenging. We're going to be knocked down all the time. But don't give up. Never give up. Have that vision, even if it's a mustard seed vision. Have it and have that same faith and go forth and keep plugging along. You might get knocked back 10 feet when you only went 2. It doesn't matter. Keep going. Keep going. Never give up. You might have to change the course. You might have to leave the scene. You might have to, you know, cut some people off. You might have to end a relationship. But you know what? Keep going. Because the people that are meant to be with you and in your life, they will stick around and they will be there. They will help build you. You don't need people that's not building you. If they're not building you, you don't need them. Those are distant people. You're passing. Hello, how you doing? Keep it kind and keep it rolling. You are a tribe within yourself. And you have people that are part of your tribe. They are the ones that see what you see. Not the vision, because they don't see that. But they can see what you're doing. They can see how you are with people. They can see all of that. And you also see that in them. It's not about just you being the center. It's about the whole. A tribe is about the whole. We all want the same thing. We're working towards the same vision. It might